Pirbright Institute is the national reference laboratory for Bluetongue virus, and we are responsible for the surveillance and monitoring of Bluetongue within the UK. Bluetongue is a double-stranded RNA virus and it infects ruminants, primarily livestock such as sheep, cattle, goats and camelids. So there are at least 24 serotypes of Bluetongue, which means that there are essentially 24 diseases, and this makes it very hard to identify and to control. Bluetongue type 3 is currently present in the Netherlands, and we're expecting cases to surge in continental Europe later this year, and this puts the UK more at risk of windborne incursion of infected midges from the continent.
At the Pirbright Institute, we run the Culicoides reference laboratory for the UK. Culicoides midges are small biting midges that transmit Bluetongue virus. So we have a network of traps across the UK. We have 18 of them running, and they're run by volunteer farmers or livestock keepers. And they look very much like the trap behind me here. We use the information that we get from these traps to understand the activity of the midges. So the midges are seasonal, so they're not active during the winter, but in the spring we need to know when they're coming back out again so that we know when the risk of Bluetongue transmission comes back. During an outbreak situation, we work closely with DEFRA to ensure that we have sufficient coverage and midge traps in the field to inform policy decisions, and this helps us in our outbreak response.
My work at the Pirbright Institute looks at how Culicoides biting midges are able to act as vectors of Bluetongue virus. What we can do with these insects is expose them to different viruses in the laboratory under high containment and explore how the virus infects these insects, how it travels through the insect's body and reaches the salivary glands, which are the most important organ as far as transmission is concerned. We can also take these insects and infect them with Bluetongue virus, and then in turn use these infected insects to infect the susceptible ruminants we're concerned with, so sheep and cattle, in our high containment facilities. And also complete that transmission cycle by feeding Culicoides on infected animals and see the efficiency of transfer from the animals to the vectors.
I'm a mathematical modeler. What that means is we take the information that's generated in the laboratories and in the field here at Pirbright and kind of elsewhere, and use that to try and predict and understand how the virus is spread, and in particular how Bluetongue spreads. So we can say, well, what happens if we put in movement restrictions of this type, so animals can't move, say, more than 100 kilometres, 50 kilometres, whatever. How does that impact the spread of the virus? Does it contain it, or does it actually still spread just as much? And if we have a vaccine available, kind of how do we actually deploy that vaccine? And then we can run the model for those sort of different scenarios and explore kind of what might the impact of all the different control measures be and different combinations of control measures.
Bluetongue doesn't threaten humans. It is perfectly fine in terms of food safety. What I would encourage farmers to do at the moment and the general public is to be aware of clinical signs, be vigilant and report suspect cases to DEFRA and APHA in order for us to be able to detect the disease early and to help support disease control.